Hello guys and welcome to my day 7 progress update for the Endless Delve event. At the moment I am at depth 950. Currently when I am recording this I am on the same depth with number 5 necromancer, so I am number 6 right now. So there's still a chance for me to end the demigod. I've missed some upgrades on the gear. I've rolled these gloves with dexterity, life and cold resist. I needed the dexterity so I can get rid of my passive point here. I also got some strength, but I forgot on which piece. Oh, I think it was on the boots from yesterday. So I don't need strength anymore here. And I am using this note right now because the increased critical strike chance for spells helps our elemental overload to proc. I also got this fractured life ring. I just rolled it with some dexterity and lightning resistance so I can fix my resistances. I still need to roll better mods on it. I'm still using this belt until I have enough prismatics to roll my elder belt, but I also need prismatics for my shield. I need to roll recover percent life on block and also recover flat life on block. So I will need to farm a lot of pristine fossils. And I also need to farm some more scorched fossils to roll a better scepter. After these upgrades, I will need to upgrade my boots. I will still go for the burning ground, movement speed, and some better life for stats. And also, another upgrade that I can make is to get tier 1 chance to avoid being stunned. And then to valid for a chance to get avoid being stunned on the implicit as well. Because right now I am using 4 of these jewels. And this is not very cost efficient. So getting like 40, 50 or even more. In fact, no, you can get like 50 and some maximum. So I can cap my stun immunity in like 2 jewels or maybe 3 to save some passive points and invest in something else. And I think this is everything for the gear. So yeah, I will just need to farm a bit more because it's really hard at this depth and I have some very bad mods right here. I don't know if I can progress this way, so most probably I will have to go back again somewhere because they have increased crit chance, multiplier, onslaught, and movement and attack speed, and it's really hard. Some of the nodes have penetration, like this node. I barely was able to do it, so I'm just dying a lot right now. I will show you a run. Oh, I forgot to buy dynamite. I am using it all the time at this depth. Okay, let's try. The damage is fine, but I have trouble staying alive because it's very deep depth and the damage is multiplied by these modes: increased crit chance, multiplier, onslaught, movement speed, attack speed, cast speed, and it's really really hard. I will show you an easier note if I can find one. I think that I will need to go back a lot. So this one, it doesn't have any damage modes. So I think that I will need to find another path to progress. So this node is about the same with crit chance, multiplier, onslaught, and also movement, attack, and cast speed. And this one, I cannot do it, definitely. So I don't even know how should I progress. Because they all have the same mods right here. And same on this way. This is really annoying and it takes a lot of time. I just hope that I will be able to progress. Let's try this way. Maybe if I can craft my shield, I will be able to do some of these nodes so I can progress. But I am not very sure. Or maybe I should get some more attack block and cap my spell block chance. But I still need a better shield for sure. As you can see, I am one-shotted. Oh, I need to Raise my second Spectre. So yeah, I will just try this node one more time. And that's it. If I can do it, I will go back in lower depths to farm fossils. They have the increased movement speed, aura, haste. This is going to be hard. Yep. Okay, I was actually able to do it. That's nice. So, dynamite is OP. Hopefully, I will be able to get past these two nodes because next one is easier in this zone. So, yeah, I think this is everything for today. See you next time.